Here at the University of Georgia Bee Lab, we do research on honeybees primarily. We're also doing research on native bees as well. Our primary focus for several decades has been looking at how we can keep bees alive, educate students on the importance of pollinators and beneficial insects. We also educate beekeepers on how to keep bees alive, but also how to extract honey, how to feed colonies. Bees are probably our best pollinators. The life cycle of a bee begins with an egg. The queen will lay either a fertilized egg or an unfertilized egg. A fertilized egg will turn into a worker bee or a queen bee. That egg will hatch into a larva. And the only purpose that larva has is to eat, and eat a lot. So it spends days doing nothing but eating and eating and eating. And depending on how much that larva is fed in its very early stages, within the first 12 to 24 hours, if that larva is fed royal jelly, it turns into a queen. It basically kind of turns the genes on to produce a queen, which is really cool. And then if it's an unfertilized egg, it turns into a drone. And a drone is the male bee, and the male bee's responsibility is to mate with the queen. That's it. And then our worker bees, which are the females, which consist of about 80% of the population inside of the colony, they do all the work. And the minute they have emerged, they start going to work. They clean out the cells, they start taking care of the young, they start cleaning the queen and feeding her. And as they age, they go through these different chores. And their final chore is pollination, going out and foraging for pollen and nectar. Bees typically live in the summer months about 6 weeks. And the reason is because they basically work themselves to death, because they've got to get out there and get the food, and not only feed what's in that hive that day, but they have to be able to store enough honey to feed that hive all year long, because in the winter months, nothing's blooming, or very little is blooming. There's not nectar and pollen that they can be gathering, so they have to collect enough in order to get through the entire season. So these back here, we call these hives. They're made out of wood, and they're kind of like an insulation. Bees normally live in the wild. They're gonna go into a hollow of a tree. And so that's what we're trying to replicate, is that insulation, that wood. And it's easy for us to manipulate. These boxes can be removed, and inside of these boxes we have frames. It's where they're rearing their young, and that's where they're storing their food. We normally will check on bees at least once a season. When we're doing research, we're going to be checking on them a lot more often. Is there a queen? Is it a healthy colony? Are there any diseases? What are the mite loads? How much honey do they have? So there's a lot of things that we check seasonally.
Usually whenever I'm going to go into a colony, I will always have a smoker, a hive tool, and a veil. We use the smoker to kind of trick the bees into thinking that there's a wildfire coming. So they think a fire is coming, they smell the smoke, so they start consuming nectar and honey. That way they don't have to leave home on an empty stomach, just in case the fire reaches their tree cavity in a natural state. In our state, we're using artificial hives. The hive tool is used to pry open the colony. Bees produce wax, honey, and another substance called propolis. It's what they actually use to glue the hive together. And then the veil, maybe the most important piece of gear. The bees, they kind of key in on contrast, so your eyes and your mouth, they're gonna kind of key on that if they do get angry. The colors bees usually key in on are darker colors. A bee's natural predator is bears or even a honey badger, mammals with darker fur. So we wear a white suit. They're not as incentivized to sting us when we're wearing light colors.
So inside of these hives, if you had a very large hive, you could have 60,000 individuals. In each box, maybe 10 to 15,000 worker bees and drones and a queen, obviously. When we're doing research at the University of Georgia Bee Lab, we normally want to have a number of different apiaries so we can move bees. That's one reason why they're such awesome pollinators, is we can pick up that hive, close them up, strap them up, throw them in the back of the truck or the back of a car, and take them to a location that we want them. So for instance, in January and February, there's millions of colonies that are transported from the United States all over the US to California for almond pollination. So that's the beauty of why honeybees are such good pollinators. There's tens of thousands of them inside of the hive, And so right now, all of those colonies that are in California are slowly moving up for apple pollination in Washington, across into the Dakotas for clover, into the Northeast for cranberries and blueberries. Then they'll come down here into Georgia for cucumbers and cantaloupe and watermelons, down to Florida for oranges. So you can move them around. And that's the beauty of honeybees. I think our bees rock.